Are they gimmicky? Yeah, but I don't care. I think they're cute anyway. So yeah. But in other pictures, it kind of looks more brown. So then I'm like, what is it? Now, I'm by no means the best eyebrower there is. I just hope to get them kind of even-ish. My beauties, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, another Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases. I have some very cutesy stuff this week, or at least I think so. So yeah, that's always good to talk about, isn't it? I did film this makeup look. It is look number one with the Neon Earth palette from Catrice. So yeah, I don't know when it will be up, but it is coming. If you want to know when it is coming, just make sure that you have hit the subscribe button and the bell so you will be notified when it is uploading or uploaded live. You know what I mean, I hope. At least, yes. Let's just move on. This video is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist is listed down in the description box, as is the community playlist that she created for people such as me who do these types of videos. And my sources are down there that will basically make it possible for me every single week to do this video. I will list the products that I mention. I have some discount codes there. So if you want to know anything, check out the description box first. And if the information that you require isn't listed, just ask in the comment section. So yeah, let me open up my Instagram. Yes, go to the side a tiny bit. And hope the camera keeps focusing on me and not on the skull that is there behind me. Okay, let's first start with something that I, well, basically knew nothing about. And that is more for my Dutchies and my Belgies. Yeah. The Netherlands and Belgium, basically, is that Kruidvat, one of our... It's like Ulta, but also not. It's one of our drugstore brands. Is coming out with its own makeup line. And it is called Udaf Krit. And it's an anagram for Kruidvat. It started online, and as you are seeing this on Monday, it should be in stores, or at least most stores as well. They have a complete range. They have foundation, concealer, they have setting powder. I'm going by heart. I wrote it down, but my notepad is downstairs, obviously. So, full face. Do they have lippies as well? I don't think they have just yet, but more complexion products. They have two eyeshadow palettes. I'm really excited about this. Usually I don't go for own brands. Like, for instance, the Douglas own brand is very good. Ici Paris own brand is very good. And Hema's brand is very, very good. Usually I don't go for that because it is only available in the Netherlands and in Belgium a lot of the time. And most of my audience is from the US. However, I am very interested in this line from Kruidvat. And I think that I will probably check some things out, because I am really, really curious. I do like Kruidvat's own, skincare, micellar water. That is what I use as well. I'm very curious. So yeah, if you have already picked something up, because this video for us in the Netherlands is going up in the evening, let me know if you have picked some up already, or if you are planning to. I am very excited, guys. They have shimmer blushes. I'm very excited about that, because I love me my shimmery blushes. But yeah, so that was for us in the Netherlands and in Belgium. So that's very sad, but yeah, every country has its own, I don't know, in-house brands or something along those lines. Let's go next to a brand that most people can get, and that is iHeart Revolution. They have released some other things, but I wanted to talk about this. I saw these sneak peeked, I think about half a year ago, around even before they launched their Bare palettes. There are four, I believe. Yes. Let's see. Each palette features 8 rich shadows in both matte and shimmer finishes. You get Stardust, which is the goldeny one. Then you get Blossom, which is the pinky one. Fluffy is the white one. And Licorice is the black one. They are £6, €8 or $9 each. And you can get 4 for 3 exclusively on revolutionbeauty.com. But also they are available at Superdrug. I saw these, and I really like the golden one. I also kind of like the white one though, because that is a little bit Easter, but I don't know, that golden one. I have it in my wish list. Just saying. Very cutesy. I don't know the quality, guys, but yeah, it could. I don't know. They are also very cute display pieces though. I kind of want one. So yeah. If you have tried one already, let me know how the quality is. I don't know, but I think they're cute. Are they gimmicky? Yeah, but I don't care. I think they're cute anyway. So yeah, let's go to Makeup Obsession next, because they are releasing a bunch, and it also kind of looks like they have rebranded, and they look sleek and almost a little bit more high-end, or at least I think so. I really like the Makeup Obsession eyeshadow formula in the cardboard palettes a lot. It's actually one of my favorite formulas. And I'm really excited. So let me kind of tell you what is in there. Let's see. They have new eye pencils, which I have some in my cart. I have the blue one in my cart. And did I only have the blue one in my cart? I don't remember. Let me check. No, I had the greeny one in my cart. Did I also? And it could very well be that I also have the blue one in my cart, but the green one I had in my cart. Okay, let's go post back. So they have eye pencils, they have brow products. So basically, I don't know what it is. It's a highlighter or something, and then a brow powder and the setting gel. I don't know exactly. I don't use those types of things, but they do look sleek and nice. They have brow mascaras. I'm very interested in those. They have a new eyeliner. Yeah, and that is basically it. So they also, I mentioned those last week, I believe, those blush sticks that I really want to try. So yeah, they are coming out with a bunch of new stuff. I also saw a foundation stick, and I was actually really curious about their foundation stick. I had one from Makeup Revolution that I did not like at all, but maybe I will like that one. I have no idea. I don't know. I'm pretty excited about this, actually. A lot of people say Makeup Obsession is the same as Makeup Revolution. Well, not for me, because if I see that I can get, for instance, Makeup Revolution and iHeart Revolution here in store, I cannot get Makeup Obsession here in store. And for me, they are, or I don't know, I see Makeup Revolution, then you have Revolution Pro and iHeart Revolution, and then Makeup Revolution, they are kind of the same family, you know, sister, daughter, whatever brand, and then Makeup Obsession is like the cousin. That's how I kind of see it. But I do really like the Makeup Obsession aesthetics and formula, so I'm pretty excited about this, actually. Okay, let's next go to ColourPop Cosmetics, because they are going to launch a Mulan collection, celebrating the upcoming live action Mulan remake. But I also know that it is pushed back from launching in theater. So I don't know if this collection is going to launch. I don't know when they are going to launch, actually. Oh, launching the 19th of March. I don't know if that date is still correct, or that they are pushing it back to wait until the Mulan movie hit releases. I don't really know. But let's go to the collection. I think that the box looks cool. Yes. When I look at the eyeshadow palette, I see it this being done a million times over. However, I do see the Mulan aesthetic in this. It's not for me. Even though I like neutrals, it's just, no, this is not for me. But I do like the collection. I think it looks pretty, guys. I like the aesthetic of it. So yeah, I think it will be a very, very big success. Let me know what you think of it down below. Are you excited or not? Let's next go to the collection that has released already, and that is their Making Mauve collection. I saw a few different pictures, and in one picture, I don't really know what color mauve is. I don't know. And I think it's kind of a pinky purple pastel all rolled into one, you know, kind of like that. But in other pictures, it kind of looks more brown. So then I'm like, what is it? So when I saw this picture, I saw pictures where I saw a brown palette with maybe a hint of a purple in it. But then I also saw Bute Beans video using the collection, and then it is more pink purple based. I actually really like this a lot. First off, I like the fact that it is cardboard packaging and not plastic. But I think the colors are very, very pretty. These are my kind of neutral shades, even though I'm more into browns now as well. This looks very, very pretty. The blushes also look gorgeous. It's just my kind of tones. Now, I was on ColourPop's site this weekend because they had free international free shipping above $30. But and I could get the eyeshadow palette. The blush that I wanted was sold out. However, if I do a ColourPop order, I want a little bit more of a bigger order because I know I'm going to pay usually shipping and import tax regardless, because it is kind of, yeah, I could have just ordered one palette when they had free shipping, but the palette that I actually wanted, the Sweet Talk palette, was sold out. So I was like, yeah, okay, so yeah, it's then kind of mute, you know? So I wish they had a European retailer and it was kind of easier for me to get this. But yeah, I do really like the color story. I think it's very, very cute. But yeah, let me know down below if you like it or not. And maybe you have already tried it. So yeah, let's next go to Revlon. Because this is... yeah, I don't know when this will launch. Let me see. Do I know when this will launch? Oh, it is. It has launched already. It retails for, say, $10. What is it? It is... the Colorstay Brow Lights. So it's one part matte brow color, one part sheen. The final look, natural brows with a subtle glisten. So if you look at the thing that she is holding, you see, if you look closely, the upper part is dark brown and then you have a goldeny part underneath. They kind of had something, well, not the Revlon specifically, but there was something, I think at least, there was something like this with eyeshadow as well, one swipe. There also was something like this with a blush and highlight. On the one hand, I kind of want to try this to see if it works. Now, I'm by no means the best eyebrower there is. I just hope to get them kind of even-ish. So yeah, but I don't really know what to make of this, guys. It could very well, did I see this in store already? It could very well be that this, I remember seeing that brushy thingy, but retailing for $10, then Revlon here, it's probably €15. And then it is a bit too expensive for me to just, you know, try out a funky eyebrow product. Maybe when it gets on, if it gets on sale, I will try it. But yeah, I don't know. It's available in 6 shades. I don't know. I don't. Let me know down below what you think of it. I don't really know what to make of it. But yeah. Okay, let's next go to Rebel Rouge Labs. Because this is their new spring collection. And their pre-order went live already. There's an eyeshadow palette called Karma Chameleon. Some jelly shadows and holo glosses. And... yeah, that palette looks really cute. It looks cute. And what I actually like about the fact is that I'm looking at the swatches now, is that Rock Lobster, which is a orangey gold duochrome. Then Take On Me is a... oh, that's what's sucking me in. Not specifically the mattes. I love the matte shades, but I have those matte shades. Those duochrome-y shimmery goodness, that is sucking me in. I have never tried Rebel Rouge Labs though. Let me know if you have. Why am I not following them? I don't know. Let me know if you have. Maybe I can kind of... I do really like their aesthetics though. That 90s, whole 90s vibes. I like that. Oh, I have a little bit more information here. So March 13 to March 29 is the pre-order window. And the orders will ship the beginning of April. So there's that. Okay, so I have here, I think, I'm not sure though, it is retailing for pre-order $29 and then the full retail price will be $33, I think. I'm not sure though, that is based on their last palette actually, but I could be mistaken. I like it, it is very, very cutesy. Okay, let's go next to Peachy Queen Cosmetics, and this is a picture of their Far Out palette. It has launched already, it looks... almost muted neons, if that is a thing. It looks to be you have a lot of mattes and then a corresponding shimmer, which I really, really like, but because that kind of means that I can play more. I like these colors a lot. I have these colors a lot, just saying. But I do think it's really pretty. I don't know, it's giving me spring Easter me wanting to paint eggs kind of vibes. I don't eat eggs, but still. Kind of want to paint them anyway. I can get fake eggs, but yeah. Never mind. Let me know down below what you think of it. So let's go to Menagerie Cosmetics next for their pastel pop palette. And you get 11 buttery mattes and one trifoil foil. And that's called Snowball, and it shifts blue, purple, pink. She's also releasing three other trifoil shades, and they will be sold as singles for $6 each. And someone commented underneath there, I wish that there were more shimmers in that pastel palette. Swap out the white and the black. I don't agree. The white, sure, swap that out for another shimmer, because I don't usually use a pure white. I can see it have a function in this palette, but I don't usually use it. However, that black or even a dark gray, yes, give me that in a pastel palette. So I can just darken up the looks if I want to. And at first I was like, yeah, but maybe she could have swapped out the green or the blue. And now that I'm looking at it, I'm actually thinking, no, I really like the palette the way that it is. Okay, granted, maybe minus the white. But on the other hand, if you pack that white onto your eyelid on a tacky base, and then just that snowball over it, and then maybe a little bit of black in the outer corner, that would be so, so pretty. The only downside is that this is so freakishly expensive for me to get here. Let's kind of break it down. I really want this palette, but let's break it down for me. I don't really know if I'm... I really want it though. But it will cost me around... let's see, she has $25 flat rate shipping. The palette is... including shipping, it was $61 for me. Then I need to pay my import tax, because I know I need to pay import tax, which is around 25, maybe $30. It's a pretty expensive palette then. And that is the trouble that I have with this palette. It is so, so expensive for me to get. I don't know. Maybe I need to get this one and then another one. But yeah, I don't know. I'm so on the fence about this palette. I really want to get this palette, but the shipping cost is kind of breaking me. So yeah. Maybe I just need to fill up my order a little bit more. I need to start calculating, because I know that there is kind of a threshold thingy. Maybe I can make it a little bit more worth my while if I order some other stuff as well. Because I really want this palette. My favorite formula is one that I can build up, so that I get pigmentation, but that I can build it up as well. Her formula is very, very intensely pigmented. And I am actually very curious to see how her pastel formula is. So, I think it's going to cost me a lot of money, this palette. Because I kind of really want it. So yeah, there's that. Okay, let's next go to Lunatic Cosmetics Labs. Because here you see a picture of their Descendant palette. It is available now for a whopping $42. Wow. Okay, let's break it down. I like the aesthetic of Lunatic Cosmetics Labs a lot. Someone says here, it's the neutral but cool toned. Yeah, palette of the dreams. I can see this being a palette of someone's dreams, but not for me. While I really like cool tone browns, sorry, but this looks boring as hell. And then for $42? No. Could use it as a face palette though, but no. Maybe it is for you though. Let me know. And yes, I know I'm saying no, boring as hell, with a very neutral look on my eyes. And I like neutrals, but not... No. Well, if this was $20, I would have said, yeah. I can see a lot of people like that. $42, come on people, this is way too expensive. You can get better shades for cheaper. So yeah, let's go next to something that is really pretty. And that is the new Melt palette, which is called Rust. And I have a picture here. This looks so pretty, however, I kinda have it. Except the yellow. Let me show you the colors that I have here in this palette. Let's see if it is what I think it is. So let me hold it like this. So it is not exact, but the vibe is there. Oh, I need to. Where is. Oh, Lord. Let me do it like this. Can I hold it like this? Sure. So let me do it like this then. So the vibe is there. The only thing I'm missing in this palette, and I don't think it will translate on camera correctly, the thing I am missing is that mustard yellow. And I'm looking at my monitor as well to see. Yeah, I have a dark brown in here, although this one in this palette is cooler. I have a kind of a corresponding shimmer. I have a warmer tone brown. I have an orangey brown. I have a kind of a mustardy orangey browny thingy going on, but I don't have that mustard yellow. For the rest, it's kind of similar to this, guys. This cost me 10 euros. It's a new palette from Catrice that I have on my eye. But I really think this palette is gorgeous. But it is not revolutionary. It is not really new. But she very, very pretty. Not gonna lie. I would love to own this. But it's too expensive for me. So if it is also too expensive for you, there are alternatives out there. Also, that bunny palette from iHeart Revolution that I talked about kind of gives me a similar vibe as well. Granted, it has a green in there that doesn't seem to be in here. But yeah, those rusty browns. I'm rusty brown, but I also have a mustard yellow here in my collection. So I think I can kind of dupe this out. But it does look really pretty. So let me know what you think down below. Oh wait, do I know when it will come? No. I don't know. I think it's a whole collection. I don't know when though. But okay, let's next go to Guerlain. And they are launching their stunning gem collection that includes new shades of their Rouge G lipsticks and cases. And you get 8 new cases alongside 14 new shades of lipstick in various finishes and 1 new balm to the Rouge G range. They're launching in Japan on the 1st of April with other regions to be, I don't know, TBC, I don't know. The reason I wanted to mention these is because they look so pretty. Way too expensive for me. And I've mentioned this before, anything that I kind of need to say in French, with the exception of L'Oreal, is way too expensive for me. It looks luxurious. It looks pretty. Yeah. That's why I wanted to mention. I don't know what these retail for. I don't think I want to know what these retail for. But that they do look cute. So yeah. Let me know if you have tried any. Okay. Let's next go to Gimme Glow and Clarity Cosmetics. Oh yeah, so here you have, I'm itchy. Here is a picture of a palette. This is a collaboration between Gimme Glow Cosmetics and Clarity Cosmetics. This is a limited edition palette and this looks very, very pretty. And kind of reminiscent of the Melt palette as well. You are missing maybe a few shades, but this does look very pretty. Okay, so it will retail for $25. It will launch on Clarity's website. It has launched already. On Clarity's website, yes. So the owners of Clarity Cosmetics and Gimme Glow Cosmetics are actually very good friends. And they thought it would be fun to collaborate with the palette. And I think they're right. I think it's cute. I think the colors, I don't know, these colors speak to me. But I have them. And it is limited edition. So it's not for me. But I did want to mention it. Because I thought that they looked very, very pretty. And maybe a good alternative to the one from Melt. Okay, let's next go to... What do I have here? Sparrow Cosmetics. You see here a picture of their tester palette, actually. This is a follow-up to their popular One Ring to Rule Them All palette. Oh, it has released already, but the picture you see is from the tester palette. This is called the One Ring to Find Them. It's a mix of mattes, shimmers and pressed glitters, all beautifully handmade. Personally, I'm not a fan of pressed glitters because I don't use them. That is it. So yeah. Overall, the shades look really nice though. It looks to be you have 2 mattes. The one called Pippin and then the Shire look to be 2 mattes. And then the rest shimmers and glitters. I would have preferred another matte. A deeper matte. either a very dark green or even a deeper brown, but that is how I like to do my eyeshadows. I have never tried Sparrow Cosmetics. Let me know if you have. I am curious. I do really like their aesthetic. So yeah, let me know what you think down below. Let's next go to Viseart, because they are launching their latest Petit Pro palette called Chouchou or Chouchou. I don't know. It's inspired by summertime travels of carefree beach days filled with snow cones and sweets. This limited edition Petit palette features 8 joyously vibrant shades of neutrals and pops of color in both matte and shimmer finishes. It has launched already and retails for $30. And yeah, it's a cute, happy palette. It is, yeah, it gives me summer vibes. It gives me summer vibes, guys. What can I say? I think it looks cute. I think it's a hella expensive, but it does look really, really cute. I've never tried Viseart because, I don't know, I just don't think they are worth it. I would rather spend my money on a smaller indie brand than this. But that may be me. That, yeah. Let me know if you like, I do really like this palette though. Just saying. Okay, let's next go to another sneak peek from Morphe brushes. Well, actually this is from Beauty News Officials. But it is a collaboration between Morphe and Sawiti. I don't know who that is. It's the 24A Artist Pass Artistry Palette and Platinum Collection of Amped Up Pigments, Drip-In Glosses by Sawiti herself. I don't know who that is. So Fly Brushes and the Mini Setting Mist. It launches the 20th of March. Oh, I have a lot of prices. That is nice.
So the palette will retail for $29 US, $38 Canadian, $44 Australian, £29, €33. The lips, the icy lips, retail for $18, $24 Canadian, $27 Australian, £20 UK, so £20, and €22. Then you get the VIP sweep. It's a 6-piece brush and face set plus belt bag, $29. US, $38 Canadian, $44 Australian, £29 pounds and €33. Then the mini continuous setting mist in Sawit Peach, $10, $15 Canadian, $15 Australian, £10 and €11.
Yeah, it's not really new though, is it? I do like the fact that the bottom two rows are seem to be a matte and then a corresponding shimmer. I like that. I like that. What can I say? Then you have some neutrally shades. It's not a bad... I don't think it's a bad... color story at all. I'm not going to get it because the bigger pants kind of freak me out. I don't know. No, it's not for me. And also what I understand is that the quality from Morphe is also pretty hit or miss, so I really don't know. And because I cannot swatch these in store, I cannot feel the shade, so I don't really know. But I do like the color story, so let me know how you feel about it. And if you know who Sawiti is, I have no idea. I don't know people. And frankly, let's next go to something that I think is amazing. That's the second collaboration between Samantha March here on YouTube and Ofra. So the PR box is limited edition. It is available as you are seeing this today. It retails for $129. And it releases 10 a.m. EST. The official launch will be Friday the 20th. All of the individual products will be permanent to the Ofra line. The highlighter, blush and bronzer will all retail for $35 each. The lip duo will be $27 and you can use code Samantha for 20% off. I think this is amazing. I know how much Samantha loves Ofra, and this is just so well deserved. And I hope that they will collab a lot. It's just amazing. I have one lipstick from Ofra and I like it. But yeah, I don't know if I can get this collab here where I usually kind of can get my Ofra products, or that I have to order it from the US. I don't know. I don't know if I will order from this collab. But I am very, very interested. And you know, I think it's just so, so freakishly cool that she gets to collab with Ofra again. I think she really, really deserves it. And she is one of my favorite YouTubers to watch. If you don't know Samantha much, I will link her channel down below. Go check her out because she is just amazing. Let's next go to the Glitz and Glam Vegan Cosmetics. This is their recent launch. It is called the Delight Palette. You have 6 shades, perfect for eyes, face and body. It's infused with grapeseed oil for a luminous and healthy finish to the skin. It comes in a luxurious glitter mirrored palette and has a sweet smell when you open it. And it is available now. I have never heard of this brand. That is why I wanted to mention it. It looks cute. It looks to be an all shimmer palette. I like the embossing. I like the colors. I like the palette. It looks cute, guys. Let me know if you have tried anything from them, maybe, and if you have tried this palette, let me know down below. Oh yeah, I don't have a lot of information about this. So, I did want to mention it though, this, because this is a collaboration between Wayne Goss and Cult Beauty. They are doing a beauty box. You can sign up for the waitlist, but I don't know anything else. I did want to mention it though, because yeah, I'm actually very curious to see what's in the box. Let me know down below if you are curious as well. I would love to try his brushes though, but they are too expensive for me, unfortunately. So, oh no. A wrong button. Let's go to the last thing that I have this week, which is from Lurella Cosmetics. It is their Electric City palette. It retails for $20 and it is live already. They also have a lash subscription. I just saw. But yeah, let me check the palette. I don't know, it looks to be all mattes, and the only kind of thing that I'm going to complain about are the two pink and the two red shades. They look very close together. It could very well be the picture. Let's see a different picture. So it is the picture, because kind of I'm looking at a different picture, and it looks to be that one of the pinks is a little bit more blue toned and the other one is a little bit more, well, less blue toned. And kind of the same with the red. The one is a little bit more orange red, and two different types of undertone in the pink, a cool and kind of a warmer one, same for the red. So I get that. I think it's cute. I think it's a pretty palette. I like the aesthetic of it and it grabs my attention. Let me know if you have tried it and if you know the brand and then how the quality is. So that was it. Let me go to the center again. That was it for my Let's Talk Makeup new releases of this week. I think it was number 78. Let me check real quick. Yes, number 78 already. Wow. So yeah, guys, that was it for me. Let me know down below what you thought of my finds for this week. Maybe you think I have missed something. If you think I have missed something, make sure to follow me on Instagram and send your pics through DM. Because, I don't know, sometimes Instagram is really weird and I just don't see what I get tagged in. So yeah, there's that. So if you send it through DM, you will know for sure that I get it, or at least I hope so. So yeah, that was it. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.